Hello and welcome. Ansys Fluent is a state-of-the-art computer program for modeling fluid flow including heat transfer, turbulence, multiphase effects, chemical reactions, and other related phenomena that must be represented appropriately in the CFD simulation. These phenomena may be selected and set up in an intuitive way using the Models group in the Physics tab of the Ansys Fluent ribbon. In this video, you will learn how to enable and set up the most commonly used models, namely heat transfer and turbulence. I already have Ansys Fluent open in solution mode with a mesh loaded in for demonstrating how to select and set up important physical models. By default, Fluent will always solve the conservation of mass and momentum equations, and equations associated with default turbulence model, namely the two equation SST K omega model. More on turbulence models a bit later in this video. However, sometimes you might want to include other physical models in your simulation. In the Physics tab next to the Solver group, you can see there is a Models group. The most commonly used physical models are energy, which allows you to include heat transfer, and viscous for defining a turbulence model. There are other models that can be included in the simulation depending on the need, such as multiphase for modeling flows with more than one fluids, solidification or melting for modeling phase change, acoustics for modeling noise propagation, and many other. A discussion regarding these models is beyond the scope of this course. Here, we will limit ourselves to the energy and viscous models. If you need to include heat transfer in your simulation, this is easy. Just tick energy in the ribbon. This will force Ansys Fluent to also solve the conservation of energy equation. Ensure that you go to the materials panel and define material properties like thermal conductivity and specific heat for all the solids and fluids included in your simulation so that the calculation of the heat transfer is correct. Then, define your thermal boundary conditions for inlets and walls using the thermal tab of the relevant boundary condition panel. These steps will be shown in more detail in following lessons about materials and boundary conditions. Next, I want to talk about turbulence, and this illustration shows the concept of the famous dye trace experiment of Osborne-Reynolds. In the experiment, dye was injected into a pipe with water flowing through it. If the water was moving slowly, the dye just flowed along with the water. This is known as laminar flow. As the velocity of the water was increased, the dye began to exhibit fluctuations, and as the velocity continued to increase, after a certain point, the dye would quickly mix and disperse. This is known as turbulent flow. So, in other words, as the speed is gradually increased, the flow undergoes a transition from laminar to turbulent motion. Reynolds found that it's not only the velocity that determines when the flow becomes turbulent. It is also dependent on the density and viscosity of the fluid and the diameter of the pipe. He combined this into the dimensionless parameter shown here, which is known as the Reynolds number. And this is the criterion used to determine whether a flow is laminar or turbulent. In the equation, you can see that the letter L is in the numerator. L is a characteristic length. In the pipe experiment, it's the diameter of the pipe, but in a flat plate, it would be the distance x from the leading edge, or in a non-circular duct, it would be the hydraulic diameter. In general, a flow becomes turbulent when the Reynolds number is high, but the exact value is different in different applications. So, for flow along a surface, the flow is turbulent when the Reynolds number based on the distance from the leading edge is higher than 500,000. For flow in a pipe, if the Reynolds number is above 4,000, then the flow is considered to be turbulent. So, the takeaways are, you can calculate the Reynolds number to determine if the flow is turbulent. The value for transition to turbulence depends on what kind of flow it is. If the flow is turbulent, a turbulence model is required or else the results will be incorrect. Most engineering flows are in fact turbulent, so the default in Fluent is to use a turbulence model. The turbulence model is prescribed in the viscous model panel. There are many turbulence models in the panel, each with applicability to different types of fluid flows. Ansys recommends the use of the default SST K omega model, as this is suitable for most turbulent flows. A discussion regarding the specifics of turbulence modeling and how and when to use specific models is beyond the scope of this course. This is covered in our other advanced courses. To summarize, in this video you have learned how to set up heat transfer and turbulence using the models group in the physics tab of the Ansys Fluent ribbon. The most important takeaways are: enable energy to include heat transfer in your simulation and then set up material thermal properties and thermal boundary conditions for inlets and walls. Most engineering flows are turbulent. For new cases, where we are not sure if the flow is turbulent or laminar, it is a good idea to estimate the Reynolds number of your flow and decide if the flow is turbulent. For turbulent flows, Ansys recommends the use of the default SST K omega model, as it is suitable for most engineering flows. Thank you very much for watching.